Hey guys, it's Sarah. Today's video is going to be a favorites video. I don't know what it is, but I feel like I've been having such good luck with products lately. Like, all of the products that I've tried within the last couple of months have been incredible, most of them. Maybe I just know my tastes now, and now those are the products that I'm gravitating towards, but some of these products I think are gonna be like holy grail status, and most of them are things that I've just recently tried. I only have a couple of makeup products to share in this video, quite a few skincare products, and then some other either lifestyle or just like fun random favorites as well. So let's get started. I think my last favorites video was my 2019 year end favorites from the whole year. So starting fresh now in 2020, a lot of these are products that I did just discover in 2020. First one is an eyeshadow palette I've been loving. It's the Shared Planet Polar Bear palette. I did a 3 looks 1 palette with this video, and then I also used it in my full face of eco-friendly / ethical brands. So I will link both of those if you want to see this palette in action. But this is a beautiful, mostly cool tone palette. I feel like I don't have a lot of cool tones in my collection, so this was a really good way for me to try out a bunch of cool tones. This has two beautiful blues in it, a kind of icy blue and then a royal blue. It is a very shimmer heavy palette. You're getting 2, 4, 6, 8 shimmers and 4 mattes. That's kind of a ratio that I prefer because I tend to gravitate towards shimmers anyway, and I pretty much only use mattes for like those staple like transition shades, or you know, the outer V deepener shade, or like as a liner. And it has kind of all your basic matte shades that you would need, and then a nice variety of shimmers. So really nice palette. The shimmers in this I have found do apply best actually just with a finger, which is fine by me. It's one less brush that I have to get dirty. So, but just be aware of that. They also apply fine with a brush, but I feel like I get a much quicker build with just a finger. So even though these are all powder shadows, they're very creamy to the touch. So I think that's why they just interact better with a finger. But loving that palette. This brand has a great mission behind it as well, so really happy to have a new kind of lesser known brand to talk about in my palette collection. The only other makeup favorite I have is a mascara. This one came out of nowhere and quickly moved up the ranks to compete with my Flower Lash Warrior mascara. That's been my gold standard favorite for a long time, like nothing compares to it until this one. This is the e.l.f. Keep Your Curl Mascara. I bought this simply because I wanted to do a full face of e.l.f. Cosmetics, which I already filmed, so I'll also link that below if you want to check it out. But I just needed a mascara for that video, and I decided to try one of their mascaras that I'd never tried before. I've tried a couple of e.l.f. mascaras in the past, and I was never hugely impressed. They were always just fine, but they weren't ones that I'm gonna repurchase over and over again. But this one had, it was one of the highest rated ones on their website. I haven't heard anyone talk about this one. I have learned, I do tend to like mascaras A, with a rubber bristle brush, B, with a curved brush, and C, I often like mascaras that have like curling in the title, because I don't curl my own lashes. It's just not a thing that I do. I don't really need it necessarily. My lashes already have some curl to them, so I just don't feel the need to go in and do that extra step. But it's nice when a mascara has that curved brush and it kind of lifts your lashes for you. It just gives them an extra little boost and makes them look a lot longer and fuller. So I've learned that about myself, I think. All of the mascaras with curved brushes that I've tried, I've really liked. I think this is extremely similar to the Flower Lash Warrior, but even more similar to the Balm Mad Lash Mascara. It gives insane length, it gives volume, the rubber bristles really allow you to get up in between your lashes and comb through them so that you're not getting really clumpy lashes, and it's just amazing. It is now probably going to be my favorite, even above the Flower Lash Warrior. Not because it's necessarily better than the Flower Lash Warrior, but just because it's as good and it's way cheaper. This one, I wasn't expecting to think it was all that special, but I'd heard good things about it, and I thought it might be a good one to try. It's their sponge. I can't remember the exact what they call this, but it's just their like fuchsia pink sponge. Very similar shape to the Real Techniques sponge, but I feel like it gets a little bit bigger, especially when it's wet, than the Real Techniques. Thing I like about it is I don't feel like it shears out the products nearly as much as other sponges do. A lot of times sponges, they give you a really pretty finish, to your makeup, but they a lot of times will really sheer out foundations and concealers, so you're just not going to get as much coverage as you would if you were to apply with your fingers or with a brush. That's been an issue I've had with a lot of sponges, and I just kind of overlooked it because the finish just looks so much better. But this one I've been using, I mean, you can see today I used, been really into the Pacifica Alight Clean Foundation. I don't know what happened, it just, I used to hate that foundation and suddenly I'm loving it. But I used that, which is a higher coverage foundation, and then the e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer on my under eyes. So you can see I'm looking pretty full coverage today. And I used this sponge to apply both. I don't feel like it sheared either one out at all. The foundation went on just as full coverage as it would with a brush. But the issue I have with brushes, I really don't like applying foundation with brushes because it seems to always end up looking streaky. I don't know if I just have the wrong brushes, but I just have an easier time with sponges. I also feel like it just blends out quicker with a sponge. So this sponge not only gives me the finish that I love with a sponge, but it also doesn't really sheer out products. I also like the EcoTool sponge, but it's been so long since I've used that one that I may need to buy it again and kind of compare it to this one to see if it's the same or different. They're around the same price, so it's just, but they're different shapes. So anyway, loving that sponge, I can totally see where the hype is coming from. Okay, so moving on to some skincare. This one I don't think I've talked about this on my YouTube channel yet. I did talk about it on Instagram stories when I bought it. Where did this come from? This is from a brand called Earth Science. The Earth Science Ceramedics Natural Ceramide Therapy Extra Dental Cleanser, fragrance-free. It says it's a sulfate-free cleanser for very dry, sensitive skin. That's me, at least this time of year. Okay, so there's a whole backstory to this. If you watch my Instagram stories, then you already heard it, but there's a health food store near me called Earth Fair. It's a kind of regional chain, and it's closing down. The entire company is closing down. Very sad, heartbreaking. Anyway, I love shopping there. They're closing within the next few days, and they were having, of course, like a, you know, everything must go store closing sale. So I went in a couple weeks ago. Their beauty section, which has a lot of skincare and makeup and just body care products, I think was 30% off, or maybe it was 20%. Doesn't matter. Anyway, they had this, and I'd heard of this brand Earth Science before, but I saw it there and I was like, oh yeah, Earth Science. This brand is cruelty free. They're Logical Harmony approved and everything. So the thing that really sucked me in was, doesn't this remind you of CeraVe? Like their whole aesthetic? Because, you know, they're ceramide based, most of their products are, you know, fragrance free, really kind of no nonsense packaging, that kind of thing. So that is why I decided to try this, also because it's fragrance free and I'm working towards a completely fragrance free skincare routine, and I have dry skin. So it just checked off all the boxes for me reading the packaging. The ingredients look great. It has ceramides, which are really good at repairing the skin barrier. Really good if you have dry skin, things like that. Sodium hyaluronate, also great for dry skin. It's a humectant. And what's the other thing? Aloe, just some really good looking ingredients. I love this cleanser. I don't know how it compares to any of the CeraVe cleansers because I've never tried any of them. If anyone has ever tried both, you can let me know. But this comes out almost like a lotion or balm texture. So at first I was like, oh, maybe this would be better as just like a first cleanse and it's not really gonna super clean my skin the way I need it to, especially if I've been wearing makeup or sunscreen. But that has not been an issue. I've just been using this as my standalone cleanser after I remove my makeup with one of my makeup remover cloths, just they're like the makeup eraser. Take off my makeup that way, including eye makeup, and then I just cleanse my face like I normally would with any cleanser with this, and it is so gentle. It leaves my skin feeling so soft. My skin, I've been noticing with my Everyman Jack charcoal cleanser, which is what I've been using, that was starting to make my skin feel a little bit stripped and dried out when I used it. I didn't have that problem when I used it a couple years ago, but now that I've gone back to it, I think my skin's just gotten drier. But this just, my skin feels like quenched after I use this. This is amazing, especially if you have dry skin, sensitive skin, anything like that. It's just so gentle and it feels nourishing, even though I never really expect my cleansers to do anything other than cleanse. It just leaves my skin feeling so hydrated. Here's a problem. It almost looks like they're discontinuing this. Now when you look at their website, there's only three products on there. Their Extra Gentle Body Cleanser, which I think is different than their Extra Gentle cleanser. And then they have like two different moisturizers and that's it. And so I'm gonna try my best to find a link to this somewhere online that's still selling it, but I'm gonna have to email them and ask them if they're really discontinuing it, because why? Why would they do that? I don't know, but I'm gonna be really disappointed if they really are discontinuing this, because this is such a great find. If you have an Earth Fair near you and it hasn't closed yet, maybe go check and see if they still have it there. A few other skincare products from e.l.f. that I've been loving. These have really helped my dry skin so much. I feel like my skin really hasn't been super dry anymore now that I've found these products. I'm actually planning on doing a skincare routine video within the next couple of weeks, I think, because my skin has been in really good shape, knock on wood, and I definitely credit the skincare products I've been using. So stay tuned for that. Make sure you're subscribed if you want to hear about my full skincare routine. But these two products in particular have been major favorites, both from e.l.f. The Holy Hydration Face Cream Fragrance Free. They did come out with a fragrance free version of this recently. So nice. I absolutely see the hype. The ingredients on this are identical to their original. They changed the name to Holy Hydration, but it used to be called their Hello Hydration Face Cream. Same exact ingredients. The only difference is that this one doesn't have fragrance listed. And I'm already like halfway through this though. That's the thing. You only get 1.8 ounces in here. I feel like I've been flying through it. And it's like a $12 moisturizer. They always have 50% off sales, so I guess I'll just maybe stock up when they're having a sale. But amazing. It's so nourishing. It feels like butter going on your skin, but it sinks in and it doesn't like leave any kind of weird greasy residue on your skin. It also doesn't sink in to where you feel like you didn't apply any moisturizer. I usually use it at night, but it also works great under makeup, so just such a good moisturizer. Really wish they would just increase the size of this container. It looks bigger than what you're actually getting. The inside part is a lot narrower than this like thick outer packaging. So that's the only complaint I have. And then also their Nourishing Facial Oil. This is also a really small bottle. This is, I think, half an ounce. Let me double check that though. Yeah, it's 15 milliliters or 0.5 fluid ounces. So not a great value. Again, I've already used up, I feel like, a lot of this for the amount of time that I've had it. But this is a really nice blend of oils. There's no fragrance in here. Again, e.l.f. doesn't have very many fragrance-free products, but they do have a few. And I feel like maybe they're moving in that direction a little bit more, especially since they came out with the fragrance-free version of that face cream. This has jojoba oil, sunflower seed oil, grapeseed oil, meadow foam seed oil, rosehip seed oil, avocado oil, and sweet almond oil. It really does make my skin feel extra hydrated, and using these two products together has honestly fixed my dry skin. And then I've already talked about this several times, you already know, but I just need to reiterate the Crave Beauty Beet Shield. Wow. Best sunscreen I've ever tried. I've been wearing it every single day since I started using it. I feel like it's the only face sunscreen I'm gonna need, except for it's not water resistant, so if I'm ever gonna be like swimming or doing a lot of outdoor activities, this probably isn't the one I'd use. But other than that, like on a day-to-day basis, this is incredible. It has SPF 50. It's a chemical sunscreen, but it's not the typical chemical filters that you find in US sunscreens. This is a Korean brand, and they are seemingly a little bit more advanced with their sunscreen research. Doesn't smell like sunscreen, doesn't leave a white cast at all, it doesn't interfere with makeup. It gives you just a little bit of glow, but it's very subtle and it kind of sinks into the skin. It doesn't like sit on top of your skin. If you've yet to find a sunscreen that you actually want to wear or that doesn't annoy you for one reason or another, try this one. It's just so good. I can't sing its praises enough. This is like a body care product, the Hemp's Vanilla Plum Herbal Body Moisturizer. I got this at TJ Maxx. It was 11 bucks. This smells incredible. Normally I wouldn't spend $11 on a body lotion, but I decided to go for it because it smells so good. Almost like a sweet, it's definitely a sweet scent, but I feel like the hint of vanilla kind of balances it out. And Hemp's makes such great scents. Such great scents. They're sold at Ulta, but I find them at TJ Maxx a lot. And I like this body lotion. It's very easy to apply. It's not one of those that you have to like rub back and forth for like 10 minutes to get it to sink in. It sinks in quickly. It feels really nice. It smells so good. The scent really lingers on my skin too, which I just love. So because of that, I end up being more likely to actually apply it when I get out of the shower because I just enjoy using it so much. And I really struggle to apply lotion to my body after a shower. It's just, I always forget to do it. I'm too lazy. I just want to be done, you know? So, but this has made me a lot more likely to use it. I still forget a lot, but it's just such a nice lotion. Speaking of TJ Maxx, I found this purse there also when I, same time I bought that lotion. This is so cute. It's quite a large purse, but I like it because I can fit my laptop in here. I go work at coffee shops a lot of the time because I work from home, and sometimes sitting at home gets really old, so it's nice for that because I can use it on a weekly, like, daily basis. The brand is Matthew and Julian. Super cute. This is $25. It is vegan leather, but honestly it looks a lot like real leather, and I love the color. It's like this kind of very light lavender taupe, and it just goes with everything. I love the gold. The other thing I really like about it is the, what do you call this? The shoulder drop length is a comfortable length. It's not so long that it's like hanging down at my knees, because I'm short and I have that problem a lot with like long crossbody bags, but it's not so short that it's like, you know, this high up and it's like cutting off my circulation. A lot of times the bags at TJ Maxx will have these really short handles and then a really long handle, and then there's no in between. But this one actually has a normal length handle, which I really like. So loving that purse. I've been using it nonstop ever since I got it. I do, whenever I'm like going out or something and I don't want like a big purse, I mean, you can see it's pretty big, I will switch to like a smaller crossbody bag, just because it is a little too big for certain occasions. But overall, it's been a really good like all-purpose bag for me. I didn't even really show you the inside. It's kind of a mess right now, but I really like the way that it's set up on the inside. It has kind of two big compartments and then a little middle zipper section and then some little pockets on the sides. So pretty standard, but I like that it's not just like one giant inside, you know, it's got some dividers and stuff. And then finally, I have two tees that I found recently that I'm loving. I've been really into tea lately. One is from the brand Yogi. I talked about this in my January vlog, but this is the Vanilla Spice Perfect Energy Tea. So this does have caffeine. It's just, it's a nice amount of caffeine where I feel like it gives me a little energy boost, but it's not the way that coffee is, you know, where it sometimes makes you kind of jittery. Yeah, Vanilla Spice is a perfect description. It's just a very warm, kind of sweet flavor. I don't ever add sweetener to my teas, but I feel like this one is just has its own little bit of natural sweetness that I really enjoy. So that one is amazing. I love so many Yogi teas. They make so many great teas. And then this is another one. I also bought this from Earth Fair during their closeout sale, but this is from Steep by Bigelow, and it is their dandelion and peach, rooibos and green tea. If you like peach tea, this is so good. Don't let the dandelion throw you off, because I was like, what's that gonna taste like? I feel like I have some right here. I'm almost done with it. I feel like you're mostly just tasting the peach. There's like a, it's not a super floral taste. So I think it adds a little sweetness to it though. So yeah, love that as well. It's like such a treat, you know? Anyway, if you like tea, those are some to check out. But I think that wraps up this favorites video. Hope you enjoyed it. Hopefully you learned about some products that you may never have heard about before and got to hear my thoughts on them. So I hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure you give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and I will talk to you very soon in my next video. Bye.